Good morning, students. How are you all? Hope you all are doing good. Okay. Have you studied yesterday's lesson? Today we are going to learn the recent development in stock exchange. So since our central government, our Indian government has started this liberalization, globalization, they have enlarged this stock exchange. They have introduced some of the new structures have been established along with the stock exchange. So that we will see some of them. Okay, the first one is National Stock Market System. This new structure is called the National Stock Market System. This National Stock Market System was established by one group. They have given that group is called High Powered Group. That group was having high power to establish new stock exchanges. Okay, this group has the power to establish new stock exchanges. Okay, this group was headed by, the head of this group was Shri M. J. Fairvani. Shri M. J. Fairvani. So we can call this group as, that it was called as Fairvani Committee. Okay, that committee only had the power to establish new stock exchanges. Now, along with the other stock exchanges, now they have introduced some more developments. They have introduced some more stock exchanges. Okay, that we will see. Around five of them are there. Number one is the National Stock Exchange of India Limited. National Stock Exchange of India Limited. Already we have learned this one, NSE. Okay, National Stock Exchange of India Limited. Okay, then the second one, Stock Holding Corporation of India Limited. Stock Holding Corporation of India Limited. Stock Holding Corporation of India Limited. This is called, in short, NSE. Okay, National Stock Exchange. The Stock Holding Corporation of India Limited is shortly called SHCIL. SHIL. Okay, then the third one is National Clearing and Depository System. National Clearing and Depository System. Depository System. NCDS, short form. Okay, now the fourth one. Fourth one is Securities Trading Corporation of India. Securities Trading Corporation of India. STCI, short form. Okay, then last one. National Securities Depository Limited. National Securities Depository Limited. Short form NSDL. Okay, these five are one of the very short answer, the eighth one. Okay, Roman number 2, 8th, you have to mark and you have to learn all these five new developments in the national stock market system. Okay. Now we will learn one by one in detail. Okay, first one, National Stock Exchange of India Limited. National Stock Exchange. In short, we say NSE. That's why it is said as NSE, National Stock Exchange. But full name, National Stock Exchange of India Limited. Okay. But we say NSE, National Stock Exchange. This National Stock Exchange was incorporated. What is the meaning incorporated? Registered. Okay. In November 1992. Here, every national means it is countrywide, isn't it? It is countrywide. The whole country, it is national, no? National Stock Exchange, it covers the whole nation. So we can say it is countrywide and screen based. Why it is given a screen based? Because everything is on the screen, that is computer based. Okay. Then online and order driven trading system. As per order only they will do the trading in the stock exchange. So order driven trading system. So which type of trading system they have? It is countrywide, screen based, online and order driven trading system. Then it is working with the help of satellite. Okay, with the help of satellite they do the trading throughout the country. Understand, full country, throughout the country they do the trading system, because they are connecting the people all throughout the country. Okay, all the people in the country they are connecting, because it is computer based, screen based, they could connect all the people. And with the computer network they are getting the members, you know, or the people, they can convey the price of the securities between the buyers and sellers. Everything will be matched and it will be done with the computer, help of computer. And all the transactions are done immediately, instantly they are doing the trade. Okay, they are instantly doing the trade, instant trading, immediately. Okay, instant trading is done. Everybody can communicate, because online, no, in the online, whatever we need to communicate, we can communicate, they will answer. So everything is done through the computer. Okay, then this NSE, National Stock Exchange, has two segments. One is the debt segment, the other is the capital segment. We know the debt instrument, capital instrument, maybe the equities. This is the debt, the debentures. And so it is doing the National Stock Exchange. Through National Stock Exchange, all the people throughout the country are doing the transactions. So it is countrywide and screen based, online and order driven system, because they get the orders from the people and through the network they connect, they transact the price of the securities, and with the computer network they make the trading instant. That means buying and selling is done on the spot. Okay, within a few seconds they complete their trading. Second one, Stock Holding Corporation of India Limited. Stock Holding Corporation of India Limited. Shill. That is the sharp one. All these, that extension of the stock exchange, you know, all these market system, it will be based on computer only. Nothing like the old pattern of buying and selling securities. Okay? Everything done through computer. Why this was established? The stock holding corporation, it was established for speeding up the trading. For speeding up trading. They have to, that means that time of trading should be fast. And for another purpose, clearance and settlement services. For clearance and settlement services. Clearance services, what is the meaning? Clearance. They will, after purchasing and selling, they have to clear up the securities. Delivery of the securities must be given and the payment should take place. Okay, that's settlement. How they settle the transaction? One who has purchased has to pay the cash, payment of cash. The other one who has sold his securities, he has to deliver the security. These two, they have to speed up. There may not be any fraud in the, or any delay, long delay in the settlement. When for clearing, any writing, the documents should be prepared. All these will be done very fast by this shill. Okay, this came into existence in the year 1986. When it came into existence, 1986. And one more thing, it is the first depository participant. I will explain what is depository existence. Sorry, depository participant. First depository participant registered with SEBI. The first depository participant registered with SEBI. Okay, SEBI, you know, Securities Exchange Board of India. Okay, that is the one who controls and regulates all the stock exchanges which are running in the country, in India. Okay, so now I will explain what is depository participant. This depository participant, here like a bank it acts, or a department of a bank. What do we do in the bank? We deposit our cash in the bank, and what we get, it will be credited in our account, isn't it? But here, this depository participant, what they do? They will get the the amount cash and they have to give the share certificate. Okay, share certificate. But this is the usual procedure, the previous procedure. After getting the cash, that means the application money, allotment money, share money, they have to deliver this share certificate to the shareholder. The one who hold this share certificate is called the shareholder. He is the owner of the company, isn't it? For the first time. Now, this depository participant is acting for the purchase of shares, purchase and sale of shares in online. Here, do not need to get the cash and provide the share certificate. A person can purchase and sell any number of shares online. So, for that purpose, this one helps. Okay, this wing, that depository participant helps. That is called depository participant. We can purchase and sell shares online. Okay, so it is the first depository participant registered with SEBI. Okay, and it is also acting as an agent of the National Securities Depository. Another depository is there, National Security Depository. Like National Stock Exchange, another depository is there, National Securities Depository Limited, the last one, okay, limited, that one. It is the agent of that organization. Which one? This SHIL, okay. But it has started its operations, that means its service, it has started in 1988, when it has been established 1986. After 2 years, it has started its functions. Its head office is in Mumbai, and it has its branches in other 3 metropolitan cities, Kolkata, Chennai and Delhi. In all these other metropolitan cities, they have their branches. Okay, have you understood? All these points you have to write, no? They will ask any 3 or 4, they may ask. This National Stock Exchange is one of the 3-mark question. Then they have asked any, I will tell you the question. It's a little big lesson having many question answers. Okay. National Stock Exchange, then explain National Stock Market System, and sometimes they may ask anyone, okay, just you understand, try to understand and keep, okay. The next one is, the third one, National Clearance and Depository System. National Clearance and Depository System. NCDS. Here, okay, the clearance you see now. So it is mainly established for the settlement and clearance of transactions. Settlement and clearance of transactions. There will be many difficulties and problems while settling and clearing the securities. To overcome those problems only, this National Clearance and Deposit System was established.
This National Clearance and Depository System was mainly established for the settlement of problems and clearance problems that arise for the clearing agencies and share transfer agencies. So many people are engaged in the trading activities. One agency is clearing agencies, the other one share transfer agencies. Because when we purchase and sell the share, that ownership of that share is transferred from one person to another person. So many formalities are there to fulfill. So to avoid all those for that problems, only this National Clearance and Depository System was established. Okay, what are the main problems? The counterparty risk. Both the party has some risk, isn't it, that one? Then credit risk. Credit risk. Then credit risk means if we they are selling that may be the future contract, the settlement will take place after a few days, that credit risk. Then bad deliveries, the document may not be delivered on time. Then long delayed delivery. It will be delayed for a long period of time. Then counterfeit script. Counterfeit, you know, in the share certificate they may have one counterfeit. Okay, then there also counterfeit means, you know, in the bank pay in slip we will have counterfeit, that we say. Then they may do some mischief, that malpractice in the scripts. Then forged scripts, they may rub something and they may write, overwrite something. All these can happen. All these will be overcome by this National Clearance and Depository System. Understood? Then the fourth one, Securities Trading Corporation of India Limited. Securities Trading Corporation of India Limited. Corporation of India. Okay. STCI. Okay. Now this one, the Securities Trading Corporation of India was established by Reserve Bank of India. Understand? Who established this corporation, Securities Trading Corporation? It was established by Reserve Bank of India. It was established in May 1994, it was established under the provisions of Companies Act. Companies Act 1956. This corporation is established especially for having an active secondary market for the government securities and bonds. There must be a secondary market for government securities and bond issued by public sector undertakings, because the public sector undertakings will issue some that bonds and securities. For that securities and bonds, there must be an active secondary market. Okay, for that purpose only this corporation was established. Understood? To have an active secondary market for government securities and bonds which are issued by the public sector undertakings. For this purpose only this Now the fifth one is National Securities Depository Limited. National Securities Depository Limited. Depositories means that we deposit, as if we deposit money in the bank, we are depositing in the stock exchange. Okay, that is called depository. Our government of India, it has enacted one separate act, that is Depositories Act. Okay, in the year 1996 only it has come into existence. Depositories Act. In August 1996 it has enacted one law. Okay, Act, that is Depositories Act. Why? For the setting up of depositories. Setting up of depositories. So that for that, in under that act only all these depositories will be registered. Okay, National Securities Depository, the National Clearance and Depository Name System, all these things were established. Okay, setting up of depositories only they were enacted this act, one law. Okay, so no need to, what is the purpose of these depositories? They may not have any paperwork. Simply entering and automatically it will be entered and it will be known to that customer, the depositor, one who has deposited. So we can say it is a paperless settlement of securities. Depository means what? Paperless settlement of securities. Here we will not get any share certificate. No, we can through online we can buy any number of shares. But we do not have any share certificate. But the number will be given, everything will be there, and we can buy any number of shares. All these facilities are there, but no paper, that no share certificate. Okay. It was this National Securities Depository Limited was the first depository in India. Okay, this is the first depository in India. It was started on November 8, 1996. Okay, it has been established in that act itself has started in 1996. In the same year end, November 8, they have started this National Securities Depository Limited, that is the first depository in India. Okay, that is called that dematerialization, another word, dematerialization. We will learn in the globalization, dematerialization, all digital India, isn't it? We have heard that Digital India, Startup India, Make in India, all these we have to do everything through online computer network. So dematerialization means we are material means one paper will be there, isn't it, for the share certificate. That they will cancel, and they will throw out that paper, and they will convert everything into they will enter everything in the computer network. That is called dematerialization. So dematerializing securities in the stock exchange commence, that dematerialization they have started in the National Stock Exchange in December 26, 1996. First, dematerialization has been started only in National Stock Exchange in the date December 26, 1996. Then, secondly, after this one, Bombay Stock Exchange or Mumbai Stock Exchange, okay. This one has started this dematerialization work on December 29, 1997. Okay, that date only, after around 1 year, isn't it? Around 1 year only, the Bombay Stock Exchange has started its dematerialization of securities. You have understood that dematerialization of securities means the stock certificate or debenture certificate that will be demolished, that will be thrown out. Okay, but instead of that, they will provide a number or in the online or through computer network or mobile network, whatever it is, they will do that dematerialization. That means they will destroy the share certificate, that paper, and it will be in the computer. Okay, you have learned all the five developments in the stock exchanges. Now we will learn about the Nifty. In the stock exchange, you might have seen Nifty's. It has gone up. So the stock exchange value trading in stock exchange is good, we can conclude. Nifty and Sensex. These two we will learn, okay. What is Nifty? It is the short form of two words. They are National and 50. That is a N, Nifty. Okay, National, that means national level. What is the meaning of this one? Here this Nifty consists of 50 companies stock, 50 stocks. That means in India many sectors are there, sector, agricultural sector, industrial sector. From different sectors, the stock exchange will select around 50 companies. Okay, 50 companies stocks will be selected. Those companies stocks only is considered the Nifty. So hereafter, if you see stock exchange news, just see, they will say Nifty, the share value of the Nifty has gone up. Okay, so that means the stock exchange level is okay. If it goes down, we can say that national economy even gets slow. Okay, so they will judge that economic development with the stock exchange also. It has an important role in the economic development. Okay, stock exchange has that impact in the economic development. these 50 companies are selected from different sectors. Around 24 sectors, they are selecting these 50 companies. That stock is considered as the standard stock. Okay, stock means here the share market. All the share, debentures, everything together called as stock. Okay, that stock will be considered as the benchmark. Which one? Nifty is considered as the benchmark for almost all the securities, especially the mutual fund. Mutual fund, we have learned, the mutual fund will consider this Nifty as the benchmark, because the mutual fund is collecting the fund from the public and they will be giving to the most popular companies. Maybe that may be providing finance for this 50 companies. Okay, that national 50 companies. So here, if the mutual fund is in a good condition, we can say Nifty is also in a good condition. If Nifty is performing well, that means the mutual fund also performs well. Okay, you have understood Nifty. Now, Sensex. Sensex. Here, it is the index. Sensex is the index which is used in the Bombay Stock Exchange, where they use Bombay Stock Exchange. It is a list of 30 stocks. They are Nifty 50 stocks. Here it is a total of 30 stocks. And they will consider the total volume of trade. Volume of trade. How much they do the trade. Sensex trade with the total volume of the Bombay Stock Exchange trade. Okay, Bombay Stock Exchange trade total volume. Okay, these two will be considered. And they will give one weightage for both of them. Each stock they will be giving one weightage. And they will compare this one, total volume of trade in the Sensex and the total volume of the trade that is carried on in the Bombay Stock Exchange. So here, as per this Sensex only, they will decide the price of the, or they will decide the demand and supply of the other stocks. Other stock means stocks of other companies. Understand? They will, as per this Sensex only, they will decide the price of the other securities. Understood now? Sensex and Nifty, then the other five stock exchanges, the introduction or the developments in the stock exchanges. So we have learned here, up to here again some more things are there in this book. What is given in box, that I will explain tomorrow. So you read this one and study this five that is stock exchanges, recent developments of stock market system. Then National Stock Exchange is one of the question answer that also you mark fully, and how I have explained to you, you can have a glance over it. Okay, thank you students.